sidewalks, and if I'm talking about this one, Jesus began to teach. Jesus sent the 12 after giving them instruction. Do not take the road that leads to the Gentiles, and do not enter any Samaritan town. Instead, go to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. As you go to find the kingdom of God in the land. Whoever is sick, go to the dead. Cleanse out the leprosy. Drive out the enemy. So you will be received before you are dead. Don't acquire gold or silver or copper for your money goods. Don't take a travel line back to the road. And I prefer to stand on your staff. For the worker is worthy of his gift. When you come to any town of old, then you don't think it's worthy instead of the same as well. Household when you enter it. And if the household is worthy, let your peace be at mind. But if it's unworthy, let your peace return to you. If anyone does not welcome or listen to your words, take the dust off your feet when you leave the house or town. Surely I tell you, it will be more tolerable in their presence than when they come in the morning and for that time. Mission for this apostles. Jesus has come down and it's time for them to go out. We never read about their experiences from an incredible person. Interesting. Jesus told them to go to the sheep. It's the one that I'm sorry, but there was an instruction. Paul writes, he says, but I'm not ashamed of the gospel. Because the gospel is the power of God for salvation to anyone who believes. First, to the children, and also to the greater. Interesting how they cut that phrase, first to the Jew and also to the greater. Yes, designed for the greater. The gospel itself has the power to put that in the mouth of the word of power. Remember, I've heard before about is divine re-evangelism. Then I released this. So one of the branches is broken off. You, though along the olive branch, were grafted in among tender care and with root. Do you not boast that you're better than those born again? Do you not think that you're better than those born again? Because if you do, you can boast. You're not part of the group. Okay, come with them, but I am the best of the but unbelief is the worst thing you can do. because they were considered as kind as them, so they're severely for those that follow. But it's kind of towards you if you remain them as them. Otherwise, you too will be cut off. And even then, if they do not remain in unbelief, we would grab to them. Let me say, I believe in Jesus, I accepted him, and I'm a blue brand. No, not right here, look at this. Healing has the power to grab people in. We can't grab anyone if we have to do it. We can get to do it. Thank you. there's the kingdom of heaven. Kingdom of heaven is at hand now. Jesus is resurrection. That is the message that the apostles got all over us. Jesus didn't say it's coming soon. He's saying it's not. The kingdom of heaven is here. It's our world. Probably a degree, and I always have busy myself as being a coach, having a good job or whatever, I could do one other thing. But yeah, change my direction. You want me to do ministry, even though I'm probably struggling with it now. And sometimes over 2 or 4 extra jobs just to cover it. And God always wants me back from ministry. Bible says to go. Oh, I wonder if I have in my mind, it's not. Pastors, today are not considered as highly as they were in all times. It's a notice of him. The church was always set up in the old mechanism, this is always the sun. You know, they used for the sun up or moons or whatever. The church was always set up in the old mechanism. You know, the pastors were considered very important. They honored God at the time. People gave them to support the pastor. Now, about today, the church is on our church. Politics is very present. You see, our culture, the way that it is, we have corrupted it. We have corrupted our politics. Politicians and doctors and lawyers and stuff like that in my congregation, you know, owning their own businesses, that 4% is donating to the caring church. But that is even worse because they don't work. They don't, you know, they're not any deaf doctor, maybe one in the whole United States, you know. There are a few. Okay. You know, you got a lawyer, maybe one or two, you know what I mean? Very small amount. Okay. But, it's making it impossible for pastors to buy the place. They need to tell you in order to preach to you, in order to gather Giving you to heaven on earth and not to the clouds or the low, not to the low. And so not no worse, but no difference. Okay, so not over south now. Take the dust off of here. Okay, in 1600s is now. This is the way to use it, not heavy now. If a word we say, forget it and move on. It doesn't bother me. It's similar to the light. Why don't you say, shake the dust off of you? Okay? You want to talk about this? This is a household when you enter. And then come up to the door, but it's easy to get on. So we're going in. Are we supposed to go in? The whole point is touch the camera. Touch the camera. Yeah. People who are not much credible. They don't want to turn in or serve or to provide a place for the residents, and they're, no, I didn't see anything. I didn't hear anything.
Really?
Oh, someone else took care of it. I can. You can take care of it. That's great. You gotta know that it hurts. Okay. Like I said, it's not. Scripture will judge your thoughts and events. Okay. Ooh. Not too much. Keep all of this online. Okay. Okay, this is true. It will be in the power of on the day of judgment. Take this up. which one of them, the person appears and sat down and upset. And one of people, the person appears. Some people are curled or sick. What was inside? What was inside the casket? A man. When they look at him, it's a man. Okay. And if it's a church, it's dead and dead. And they realize it. None of these ones. It's the church. They don't get involved. through with this one. That's loving your neighbor. That's really good. Love that. Beautiful. This kind of woman, too. People love not loving you. That's a little bit. Father and mother. Look at the disciples. They put the body, they murdered. You see the example. You see the gospel forever. And who will come, help us grow. You never know someone who comes and never had a mission. You know, like the song says, I need you, you need me. You never know how it's going to benefit us when someone comes into our lives. But people will not skip church. They will repent if they're coming to church. You know, they won't mess. You know, if they're sick or something, you have to understand something. And that could skip because they're comfortable and they stay home all the time. You know, the order slip or the order of prayer. You know, people that don't have eyes, move that really kind of people to pick up people and bring them in. And you know, we pray that we will come where it's at. We will hear them. And that's true for that. Okay. Trust that you will provide. And when you send, you're going to run to the throne of prayer. You give us the mercy. You will help us to do more for your glory. We love you. I'm the one. Thank you. Jesus, that's not the prayer.